Hello and welcome to this tutorial. I'm Dennis Mann, the developer of the Android app RF Analyzer, and in this video I'm going to show you how to set up the app and get everything running so that it can start receive signals. So RF Analyzer is a SDR app. SDR stands for Software Defined Radio, and that means you need an external Software Defined Radio device. And the app is compatible with both the RTL SDR, which is a dongle like this, and the HackerF device, which looks like this. And you also need to connect the device to your smartphone and USB OTG dongle. So this one was and came with my phone, so you might already have this. But you can also buy it for very cheap like this. I just bought off Amazon. And if you have a USB-C docking station like this, this would also work. All right. Now, first of all, we have to connect the SDR device to the phone. I'm going to use this OTG adapter here, just plug it in to my RTL SDR, and now I'm going to plug it in to my phone like this. And of course I need to connect an antenna so that we are able to receive signals. Then you start up the app, and at the first startup it's gonna ask about a permission to show a background notification. So this is when the analyzer is in the background, that you see that the analyzer is still running. I'm gonna allow this by pressing OK and then allow. And then you're in the tutorial where you can swipe to see everything you need to do to get up and running, but you can also just watch this video, so I'm gonna skip this. And now this is the main screen. You have this control drawer down here, which you can also move, and you can also hide it completely and bring it back with this button. There are different tabs for different settings and actions in the app, but we're gonna go over this. So let's first set up the correct signal source, which in this case is the RTL SDR. And when I first start this up, so if I press play and I have not installed the RTL SDR driver yet, then I'm gonna have to install it from the Play Store. It's a free app, you can just follow this link, pressing here. And now I'm in the Play Store, this is the app, and I'm gonna press install. So you might already have this installed, then the pop-up does not even appear if you use it for other SDR apps. It's installed now, you don't have to open it, just go back to RF Analyzer and just try again. This time it's gonna ask for the permission to open the USB device, which we're gonna allow, and then you see signals here. At the top there's the FFT and at the bottom the waterfall display, and you can now move with swipe gestures through the spectrum to see what's up there. So here we are in the FM broadcast radio band where different FM stations are, and yeah, you can also zoom in if you use pinch to zoom. If I touch the vertical axis, I can also move this down or up a bit, and you can see that also the waterfall coloring changes, so this is linked together. If you want to have a bit more control over how things are showing in the FFT screen, go to the display tab. There, for example, you can increase the FFT size, which is always a good idea if your phone is capable to do this. I think most modern phones should be able to have it at maximum. And you can also increase the frame rate to have everything run a bit more smoother. Now, in here you can also see that there's a fine-tune setting of the vertical scale. So I usually recommend just pressing auto scale, but if this does not work really for you, you can always reset it with reset scale, and you can manually put in a top cutoff point and a lower cutoff point for the vertical axis, and now you have it set up so that everything looks really clean. Now, the main feature of this app is definitely the demodulation, so you can do audio demodulation of analog signals. I'm going to decrease the volume already a bit so that it's not laying over my voice. You can also disable audio completely if you'd like that. And now I'm going to select a demodulation mode. So in this case we're in the FM radio band, so I select FM ride, and a channel selector appears, which is not tuned to the correct channel yet. I can either press anywhere on the screen to retune and reset this channel frequency. I can also enter it manually here. And I can use this tuning wheel to just go over each channel and easily find the one that I'd like. And now you can hear volume. You can increase the volume now. And so I came to see him and listen. All right. There are many more options here. There's a squelch option. But yeah, just experiment a bit with the app. By the way, if you want to know about any control here, for example, if you don't know what squelch is, just long press on this label, a bit longer, and the manual is going to appear at the exact point where it explains about this control. So in this case, the squelch control option is explained, but you can use this anywhere in the app. So if you want to know about signal source, and what you're going to select, then just press here. You can find the full menu over here in the About screen and just press the About menu button, and then you're in the menu and there's a lot of things explained here. This is offline, by the way, you don't need internet access for this, and you can also find the menu online. All right, and that's it. I hope that worked for you and you're now able to receive signals. If there are any issues, then maybe consider looking into the manual or ask a question on Reddit or just write me an email and we should get it working for you. I hope you have fun exploring the spectrum and see you and goodbye.